Have you ever wondered what would happen if the Earth stopped spinning? It's something we take for granted, but actually plays a huge role in how we live and the fact that life is able to exist on Earth in the first place. There's far more at stake here than just the cycle of day and night. And if it were to happen, it could spell the end of our planet as we know it. Currently, the Earth spins at about 1,037 miles or 1,668 kilometers per hour, which means that one day, or the time to complete one full rotation, is 23 hours, 56 minutes, and 4.1 seconds long. This hasn't always been the case, though. Back when the solar system was forming, a cloud of matter formed into a disk that circled the sun. Over time, this material came together to form planets, moons, and everything else. This initial force translated into a rotation of the Earth when it formed, but it's also thought that in the early stages, a large object around the size of the planet Mars collided with the Earth and sent it spinning much faster. Back then, one full day on Earth would have only lasted 6 hours. Normally in space, where there is no friction, an object should retain its momentum forever. But the Earth is subjected to friction from the gravitational pull of the Sun and the Moon. The Moon has a much bigger influence, which can be seen in the way that it causes oceanic tides. As a result, measurements have shown that the Earth's rotation does seem to be slowing down, although at a minuscule rate. And in 100 years' time, one day then will be 2 milliseconds longer than today. Eventually, Earth would stop spinning, and some predict that it will happen in about 50 billion years. However, our sun is thought to have only 5 billion years left to burn, so the chances of life on Earth actually experiencing a complete stop of the rotation is pretty slim. However unlikely it is, if something were to cause the Earth to stop immediately or within a few minutes or hours, we would be in serious trouble. Everything that's not attached to the Earth would continue to have momentum, so the atmosphere and oceans would scrape the surface clean of all topsoils, trees, buildings, and even life, and release them all into space. Even if this happened over a short period of time, everything would experience such a large force of deceleration that they would all fall over. On the other hand, a gradual slowdown is much more realistic. While this will eventually happen, it could occur sooner if another large object in space came close to the Earth and exerted a strong gravitational force. While buildings would remain standing, conditions would become very different. If Earth slowed down to the point where it rotated once every 365 days, it would become what is known as sun-synchronous. This would mean that one side of the planet would be constantly facing the sun, and the other side would be constantly facing away from it. The temperatures on the side facing the sun would be much hotter than our current equator, and the side facing away from the sun would be extremely cold due to the lack of light. This isn't a completely stopped rotation, but due to the sun's gravitational forces, it would be as close to stopping as the laws of physics would actually allow. But let's say we slow down even further and lose spinning momentum altogether. This would mean that wherever you were on Earth, you would experience 6 months of daytime followed by 6 months of nighttime. Not only would this affect temperature, but also weather patterns. Winds would start blowing latitudinally from the equator to the poles as opposed to longitudinally and in parallel with the equator like it does now. In combination with the iron core, the spin of the Earth is also thought to create a dynamo effect that is responsible for magnetic fields. If the rotation ended, the natural protection from cosmic particles that's provided by the magnetic field would end, and result in the planet being bombarded with solar rays and radiation that would obliterate all life. The centrifugal force of the Earth's spin is the reason why the oceans remain spread across the globe. Without it, all the water would congregate at two massive oceans at the poles. Antarctica would be fully submerged, as well as everywhere lying north of Spain. With the increasing temperatures, all remaining pools of water would evaporate and end up in the poles due to the new wind patterns, and the only viable place for life to exist would be a thin strip of land on the coast. That is, if life were still possible under all of the other harsh circumstances. It's thought that the centrifugal force of the Earth is crucial in the initial development of embryos, as well as allowing organs to separate and form in the correct places. Life as we know it would quite literally change forever. The Earth's rotation is a key component in making it an ideal environment for life to thrive. Without it, the weather, atmosphere, formation of life, and the entire structure of the Earth's surface would change drastically and become inhospitable for humans and most life. Luckily, the chances of the Earth stopping are very small, and at our current rate of slowing down, the death of our sun seems to be, for now, a more pressing concern. Thanks for watching! Let us know what you think in the comments below. Give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe and click that bell icon so you don't miss our newest episodes. See you soon!